Hi friends, today we are going to solve inserting a node into a sorted double linked list problem from linked list of data structure. The problem statement given here is, given a reference to the head of a double linked list and an integer data, create a new doubly linked list node object having data value data and insert it at a proper location to maintain the sort. So basically, we have to insert an element inside our double linked list, but at the position so that we are able to maintain this sort. So sorting of the linked list. So first, we will create a variable as we always do. And in the double linked list node, we'll be passing our data variable. And we could also check the function of the double linked list node. This is the class reference, which basically states it. Let's close it. Once we have done that, the first condition, what if our LL list is empty or basically none? Then we will simply return the node. Return node. Next condition, elif data value is less than ls dot data, means the next data ls dot data. Then we will be adding that to the node dot next equal to list. Previous value equal to node, and we will be returning and the last statement, else if the data value is greater than the ls data, then node equal to, basically to perform recursion. ls dot next dot data spelling errors. List dot next equal to list. List dot previous value would be equal to node value, and we'll return our list. I hope it would work. Let's run the code. Okay, time limit exceeded. Let's try it max recursion depth, I guess. Let's see. It's not required, let me check. Okay, just a mistake. executes it past all the test cases. We could also this will maintain the way. Yeah, again taking some time. I hope it passes the test cases. Yeah, as always, please send me your feedbacks. If I'm not able to explain it properly, I would explain you again in this video, but I think the code would greatly help you. It's basically basic functionalities, nothing special, just few lines of code. And please send me your feedback if you do have a better approach to solve the same problem. Please contribute so that I could teach in a better way. And as always, thanks for watching the video and stay tuned.